Oh my God. Look at it. It's so effing cute.
Hey guys, so we're gonna get right into it. We're gonna start off with draping on the stand, and I'm doing this with tape so that I can go ahead and put my pattern pieces directly onto the paper. I align all of the pattern pieces by the waistline. That's why I drew a straight line on the paper beforehand. Once I have them all placed where they need to be, I adjust the measurements by my own measurements because I am a bit larger than my dress form. That is how I get my official pattern pieces. Once I have my pattern pieces, I go ahead and I cut them out on my muslin fabric to get my sample ready. Sew together your pattern pieces that you cut out on the muslin, and then you can go ahead and give them a nice press, and then you're ready to do your first fitting for your sample. Okay, I am going to do a small fitting of the dress. That's why I'm topless right now. I'm gonna go put it on. I didn't put a zipper in the bag because I'm just lazy. So. This is it from the side. If anything, I will probably just make the bust go in by maybe like a quarter of an inch just to give it a firmer, like a more, just to make it less prone to falling, I guess. The back feels fine. I think everything else is pretty much good. Like, there's space in the hips a little bit, but it's not like drastic. So I don't know if I want to take it off the side seams or the actual butt part. Like, you know, like, I think that actually lays pretty well on the buttocks. I think it lays well. So everything fits, but if I wanted to take off a little bit just to make it a little bit more snatched, I would do it from the side seams. There's ease in it. It's very comfortable. So I think I would take off maybe like, I wouldn't take off anything from my waist, but right here, maybe like 3/8 of an inch. Do I want to change anything in the front? I don't think I want to change anything on this front seam. I think I'm happy leaving it as is. But this side, you know, I think that'll be better like that. So I'm going to go make these changes, and then I will be right back. Okay, I've sewed everything up and I am currently in it. I got to do something about the hips now that I've taken it in. They're kind of pointy, so I'm just going to end up curving down all the way to the seams. I'm going to take it in by 1/4 inch, the rest all the way down, and then I will be completely satisfied. I think it'll look really nice.
I'm not gonna change anything on the back. The length is fine to me. But yeah, I think this is really good.
Once you are confident with your pattern pieces and you like the way that they fit and you've made all the adjustments necessary, go ahead and cut your pattern pieces out on your fashion fabric. That way we can go ahead and start sewing up the outer shell. Before I press my seams open, I am going to cut them with pinking shears to make sure that they don't fray. Another alternative is to just do French seams, or you can run your fabric through a serger beforehand. But once you've pressed everything open, go ahead and draft your ruffle. I did not get to record the process of making my ruffle, but I will tell you that my ruffle is 6 inches thick, and I sewed my gathering stitch 2 inches away from the hem, and that is how I was able to get that one side to be larger than the other side. It wouldn't be the same if you did it directly down the middle, so you want one side to be larger, most definitely.
We just sewed the ruffle onto the dress. So I have not decided what kind of fabric I want to use for a lining yet. So just to make sure that I can wear it and take pictures in it, I'm going to attach the sample that I made, the toile, this, out of cotton fabric. I'm gonna just attach that as the lining and guys, like, oh my god, look at it. It's so effing cute. It's so cute. It is so cute. And it's not too short. My booty not out for once, you know. I'm looking at the mirror behind you guys. That's why I'm like not focused. Okay, it's not hemmed yet, so that still needs to happen. And I think I want to do a rhinestone trim, like, along the ruffle. But I'll do that, and I'll hem it. And for future reference, I will make the straps adjustable, because I feel like they're a little bit too tight. I probably could have added, like, a quarter of an inch, and they would have been, you know, probably perfect. Maybe even an eighth. They just feel like they're like right on me. And I just based it off of my dress form. But I guess my shoulder's longer than hers. I don't know. But this is the view from the back. It's boring, but whatever. That ain't the point. The front is a party in the front. And that is all that matters.
I'm gonna hem the ends of my dress with hemming tape. I find that this is an easy way to get a nice clean finish on a hemline if you don't want to have, you know, stitch lines visible, and if you don't want to sit there and hand stitch it all day long. So be sure to pick up some hemming tape. It is like a life blesser, honestly. It is one of my favorite things to use on nice gowns and dresses and things like that.
I got my head out the sunroof. I'm blasting my favorite tunes.